starting in this case with six airplanes, starting a line abreast formation, and when they're in position to start, well, we release them to proceed with the race, which they apply race power, which is as much as they've got in most cases, and they fly the prescribed course, which is an oval-shaped course of about 3 miles of length, and pass as they can, which these several of the airplanes are very closely matched, so it makes for good, keen, close, serious racing. And after 10 laps, the race is done, and they get points for that. One of the most dangerous things you can do is an inside pass, and so those are precluded here because it can be very dangerous. So we've restricted it to passing only on the outside, so it's not quite a free-for-all out there, but that's the way normally air racing is done. And that's about the only restriction, obviously. The passing aircraft has to maintain, has to yield to the airplane he's overtaking until he's well clear in front, and then the other airplane becomes the wingman. We've set up a very nice course here this year. The pylons are good to see, the course is good, and they get a chance to do some good racing, but at the same time, most of them are not experienced in that particular discipline. So with some practice and training early on and getting everybody sort of schooled up so they can do it well and do it safely, we are now to the final day when we can go out there and actually compete head-to-head and see who is going to be the fastest in the end of the day, and the scoring then goes together for final results, which go to the podium tonight.